1.
Absence of digital signatures. In all the 368 precincts in the 3rd District of Comsur under Villafuerte's election protest, only the chairman of the Board of Inspectors signed the election returns. 2. But the law explicitly mandated that all 3 members of the Board of Inspectors must digitally sign the election returns.
The 3 did not put in any digital signature in all the precincts in my district.
Since only 1 member signed the election returns, the votes become invalid.
It is provided in the law that there should be a digital signature of the chairman, of the BI, the board of the member.
I saw a lot of people, sir, that showed 3 digital signatures and none of them were chairman. The law actually requires 3 digital signatures, one of which is the chairman. If one of them doesn't show up, then we have a problem. So I cannot understand how this is happening.
COMELEC issued resolution number 8786, directing all the PEIs not to digitally sign the election results.
Merong electronic signature. Walang nasunod yung electronic signature. Tinanggal yung electronic signature.
The COMELEC and Smartmatic were so brazen in their cheating because they know they will never be caught. Because in the automated election system, cheating is almost impossible to trace.
The reason for a digital signature is to secure that the person that signed it is that person.
And the authentication for the digital signature will be the basis for the confirmation of the vote winner.
The signatures of the 3 members of the Board of Election Inspectors have always been the basis for the proclamation of the winning candidate, even in the traditional or manual elections.
So I cannot understand how this is happening.
This is cheating. How can candidates be proclaimed if the election returns are not signed by all 3 members of the Board of Inspectors?
So there is no validation, which is why there's no check and balance.
By painstakingly analyzing every data, every figure, every line of 1 million decrypted pages, we now haven't covered the concrete evidence of COMELEC and Smartmatic's election fraud number 1, COMELEC fraud number 2, false mirror image. For the vote counting machine to count the ballots, it must optically scan the ballot inserted. The digital scanning of every paper ballot should produce a faithful reproduction of the image of the paper ballot. In all the 368 precincts under protest, there emerged a strange square image in the scanned ballots instead of the oval shadings.
The law provides for an optical scanning of the ballot inserted, so no alteration can be made.
Nobody knew about the square image until it was discovered in the decrypted documents.
The COMELEC never announced to the entire world that there will be squares in the scanned images.
It was shown during the source code review.
We did not see that in the source code review.
Was it mentioned that there will be
No. We were not apprised of any information that there will be an insertion or a deletion on the image.
Cheaters are the best liars.
We showed that it was available there. We didn't hide that functionality there.
On the official box on the square, that was never actually discussed through the source code.
And if we had seen that in the source code, we would have objected to it immediately. Because you have the ability now to tamper.
Executive Director Tolentino made a scientific and scholarly explanation why COMELEC and Smartmatic have to insert the square image.
The square is to facilitate the visual determination of how the machine appreciated the ballot.
Ano raw? Pakiulit niya?
The square is to facilitate the visual determination of how the machine appreciated the ballot.
Bagsak yung explanation niyo, COMELEC, about the presence of the square. Bagsak yung explanation niyo, COMELEC. Bagsak.
But here is a simple explanation why the squares have to be inserted by the COMELEC.
Inserting a square, you're actually leading any revisor to be biased.
facilitate the visual determination.
The revisor should see the panel objectively. By already providing a square there, the revisors will now tend to follow where the square is.
In this decrypted ballot from a precinct in Calabanga, Consur, it clearly shows that both Bordado and Villafuerte have strange dots, not ovals. But the vote went to Bordado because his dot had a square.
I have seen a ballot image wherein our candidate for a vice president, I will not name the vice president, both ovals were shaded and you would expect for the two squares. Unfortunately, when I saw it, there's only one square for one particular candidate, despite having two fully shaded ovals for the two candidates for the vice president. How is it possible?
How is it possible that after cheating us in three elections, Smartmatic is once more given the contract to cheat us in 2019?
And what is being counted is what is already pre-programmed, not the ballots that have been inserted.
Comment thought number 3. Missing sequence numbers. Every ballot cast has a sequence number like a receipt. So if there are 300 voters, the sequence will be 1 to 300. However, in the documents decrypted, it was discovered that there were jumping sequences. In this example taken from the election returns of precinct 1724-0001 in Naga City, it clearly shows how sequence number 180 jumped to sequence 278. Translation: 97 votes went missing from the votes of Congressman Villafuerte. These 97 votes did not go missing, but were either reassigned to the competing candidate or were simply deleted. Here's another evidence from precinct 1724-0010. The sequence jumped from 1 to 134. From precinct 1724-0002, the sequence jumped from 1 to 115. Here's a ballot from the precinct in Calabanga. From sequence 432, it jumped to 493. Multiply those missing sequences in every precinct, and the result is catastrophic. Congressman Villafuerte lost 37,200 votes because of these jumping sequences.
The sequential ID numbers of the ballots inserted, they are jumping. And in my district, we discovered that there are at least 35,000 ballots that have been removed and the replacements were made in the end.
Number 4. SD card substitution. The audit log is considered the black box of the vote counting machine. Any activity from turning on the machines to the entry of the first ballot to the transmission of the election returns. Any activity, repeat, any activity is recorded just like the black box of an airplane. In this glaring piece of evidence, it clearly showed that the SD card from the polling center of Mac Mariano Elementary School in Naga City was substituted. The first activity is recorded by the audit log as entry number 1. But here, the audit log entry number started at number 2603. Repeat. The audit log entry number started at number 2603. Where are the audit log from 1 to 2602? Here's another audit log from Sibobo Elementary School. The audit log started at 1845. Where are the audit log from 1 to 1844? Here's another audit log from Mabolo Elementary School. The audit log started at 2,496. Where are the audit log from 1 to 2,495? Clearly, the SD card was substituted. The audit log of an SD card that was substituted would produce a few pages of recorded activities.
A cluster precinct in Naga City, numbered 1724-0001. This is how thin is the audit log.
The audit log of an SD card that was not substituted would produce 100 pages of recorded activities.
compared to the same city, another precinct, the audit log consists of this whole thing, and all the anomalies are there.
All in all, 35 SD cards from 35 clustered precincts. In the 3rd district of Comarines Sur, the turf of Lenny Robredo were substituted. Lenny got what she bargained for. She has the Comarag and Smartmatic to thank for. Number 5. Early transmission. Evidence proved that a day before the election, May 8, vote counting machines were already transmitting results to the City and Municipal Board of Canvassers.
A transmission activity was captured as early as May 8. 9:17 in the morning of May 8, nag-transmit na lang apat na beses. The early transmission activity continued until May 9, 2016 in the morning, prior to the official conduct of the elections. These are only examples of the numerous early transmissions to different municipal and provincial board of canvassers in Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. These transmissions cannot be in any way claimed as testing transmissions. Because as far as I can remember, the last official testing was made on April 23, 2016. The testing transmission was one day before election and all the way until election day.